Hi, and welcome to my channel. We continue our course from where we left. Let me open the project. In this video, we'll start adding structural beams to our project. Let's check our floor plans disciplines and arrange them according to their type. We've changed a couple of them in the last video. Change the discipline to architecture if the plan is architecture, and to structure if the plan is so. Okay, now in level 1 structure, hover over one of the grid lines, then right click and choose Hide in the View category. Now the plan is clear. Do the same with level 2. Okay, we have a column away from its place here. Let's fix it. Click it, then use the Move tool to move it to the side. Now from the View tab, let's create a structural plan for the roof. Hide the grid in this plan too. Change the view to wireframe to see the columns. Now from the Structure tab, click Beam and let's start making some beams. Let's load a concrete beam family. Change to the Metric folder. Then go to the Path English US Structural Framing Concrete and choose the rectangular beam. Check its sizes and let's create our own. Click Edit Type. Duplicate and rename it to 200 by 300. Change the dimensions to 20 by 30. Now click at the midpoint of the column and drag it left to the facing column. Let's check it in 3D. Okay, this view is cluttered. let's make a structural 3D view that shows structural elements. Click the plus sign at the 3D views to show this view, then rename it to 3D structural framing. Hide the grids and levels in this view. Now on the keyboard, press the letters VV or VG to show the visibility graphics menu. In the menu, scroll down and uncheck the walls option. Now the view is cleaner. Rotate the view to see our beam. This is it. By the way, this beam is embedded in level 2's floor, so you will only see half of its height. Let's make a section in this area. Double-click the triangle head to open the section view. Notice you only see the half of the beam's height because the other half is embedded in the floor. We use this way in practice because it's cost-effective. You'll be able to cast both the floor and beams in one go. Now back to level 2 and let's make other beams. Connect each two facing columns with a beam. If there are several columns in a row, then drag the beam from the first to the last. Okay, use the move tool to move the beams to the floor's edges. In the 3D view, rotate to see our beams. Okay, in the same way, make the remaining beams. Use the align tool to align the beams to the floor edges. Use the trim tool to connect the beams. Pay attention to the possibility of extending a single beam to several columns laying in a row. We need a column in this area. Let's copy this one to that area. If you noticed, I didn't create all the columns in the previous video. I did that for a purpose. I wanted the beams to lead me in case an extra column was necessary. Design at the minimum, then let the beams lead you to an extra column. Now pay attention here. If you have an element selected and you rotate, then the element will be at the center of the rotation. If there was nothing selected, then the whole view will be rotated. We need another column in this area. Let's copy one to there. Now that's fine. Notice here there is nothing selected, thus the whole view is rotating. Let's copy this column to the edge, we need one there too. Let's copy the column again to the other end of the patio. It's space to flip this column, then move it to the edge. Flip the other columns that lie on the same row with this one and align them to the edges. We want our beam to be parallel to this row of columns. Notice I started this course creating the walls first, then the columns, then the beams. I use this procedure in design because dealing with columns, places is easier than a whole wall. Now it's a parallel. Keep navigating between different views to notice any conflicts. We need another column here. Let's copy the one next to it. Now we can extend this beam to the new column. Delete this beam and let's extend the one just created even more to this area. Now let's go to the roof plan and repeat the process there. Wait a minute, this column needs adjusting. Okay, it's off the edge. Let's check level 1 and see what is there. It's 3 wall intersection. Let's flip it and align it with the edges. Now it's okay. Let's make the beams of this level. Make sure the beam type is the same. Change the discipline for this plan to structure. See, in level 2 we have two columns in this area. Let's extend the height of the second column to the roof so we can see it there. See, now we have it. Change the view to the hidden option to see the beams as dashed lines. Now I want you to notice this area and see the equivalent part in level 1 plan. Notice it is the bathrooms area. Now in the roof plan we need to add extra beams in this area because it mostly will carry the weight of the water tanks. So let's add a couple extra beams here. Use the dimension tool to divide the distance equally. Okay guys, that's it for this video. Don't forget to like if you are enjoying the course, subscribe if you want future content, and share your thoughts in the comments. Be in peace.